this is the lecture number 2 for the chapter straight lines for the class 11th. In the last lecture we have discussed about the slope of the line and what is the condition for the parallel lines and what is the condition for the perpendicular lines. Now we'll discuss how to find the angle between the two lines. So let us take two lines which is intersecting each other. Let us take a line this and there's a line this, and if the slope angle of inclination of one line be alpha 1 and the angle of inclination of the second line be alpha 2, this is the line L1, this is the line suppose L1 and this is the line L2, and this is the angle theta between the two lines. It can be this angle also because the vertically opposite angles are equal, and let us call this angle be phi. Now the slope of the one of the line will be, let us call it M1, which will be equal to 10 alpha 1. This is the slope of the line, and the slope of the second line we call it M2, and it will be 10 alpha 2, that is the tangent of the angle made by the line with the positive direction of the x-axis. Now because theta is equal to, or we can say that alpha 2 is equal to theta plus alpha 1, that is exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. So theta will be alpha 2 minus alpha 1. Taking tangent on both sides, it will be 10 alpha 2 minus alpha 1. Now using a formula of 10 a minus b in the right hand side, it will be 10 a minus 10 b upon 1 plus 10 a into 10 b. Now 10 alpha 2 is m2, 10 alpha 1 is m1, similarly 1 plus m1 into m2. This is the 10 theta, that is the angle between the two lines, which is this angle, which is the angle between the two lines, which is the angle between the two lines. Now the angle between the two lines is phi also, which is equal to 180 minus theta, which is equal to 180 minus theta. Now if you take the tangent on both sides, the 10 phi will be equal to 10 180 minus theta, which will be equal to minus 10 theta. That is the 10 phi will be equal to the negative of this, which will be m2 minus m1 upon 1 plus m1 into m2. That is because this value is positive and this value is negative. It means this will be a obtuse angle and this will be a acute angle. Now if in case this is positive, suppose this is positive, then naturally it will be acute angle, and this will be 180 minus theta will be obtuse angle. Suppose this angle come out to be 30, then it comes out to be 150, 180 minus 30. So in case if this is positive, then this angle will be acute and this angle will be obtuse. And if suppose this is negative, then 10 theta is negative, it means this angle will be obtuse and this angle will be acute. So we always try to find the acute angle between the two lines. So in that case, the angle between the two lines will be modulus of m2 minus m1 upon this. So acute angle we have to find. Acute angle, you can write the obtuse angle also. Theta, then 10 theta will be equal to m2 minus m1 upon 1 plus m1 into m2. This is the acute angle between the two lines. Now in the class 10th, you have done the when the two lines are to be collinear by using the area of the triangle, by using the area of the triangle. Now we have discussed in the beginning or in the last lecture also, the two lines are to be collinear if the area of the triangle equal to zero. Now according to the slope, let us take any three points on a line, let us say A, B and C, then the slope of AB and the slope of AC will be equal to each other because they all lie in the same straight line. For the points to be collinear, to be collinear, then the slope of AB must be equal to the slope of AC, or the slope of AB is equal to slope of BC. For the two lines to be collinear, they must lie on the same straight line, and the same straight line will make a same angle with the positive direction of the x-axis. It means their slopes will be equal. So now you can prove that the two, three points to be collinear, if the slope of AB and slope of AC, or slope of AB and BC are equal, the one point should be common, AB, BC, AC, AB, or CA, CB. One point should be common. So this is some basics for the coordinate geometry, or in your class 11, the main thing is the slope of a line. Perpendicular lines, when they are parallel, what is the angle between the two lines, and so on. And how can we say that the lines are collinear? The lines are collinear, the points are collinear if the slope of AB or AC, AC or BC are equal to each other. So this is the condition you have done. Now we are starting with the exercise 10.1 of your NCERT book. That is the question number 1 of your NCERT book of exercise 10.1. Now what is given in the question number 1? You have to draw a quadrilateral. You have done this question in your class 10th also. And the coordinate of all the vertices are given, that is minus 4, 5, 0, 7, 5, minus 5, and D as minus 4, minus 2. You have to find the area of this quadrilateral. You can find the area of this quadrilateral. Now, if we join the point and you can join any two points, find the area of both the triangles formed and added. So minus 4, 5 is the point, and if you join this AC, you first of all find area of the triangle ABC. You can find the area of triangle ABC by using the triangle formula, which is half modulus of x1, then y2 minus y3 plus x2, y3 minus y1 plus x3, that is y1 minus y2. This is the area of triangle ABC, and area of triangle ADC also. You'll get the area of the quadrilateral. So half, you find the area of this triangle ADC, x1, y2, minus y3, plus x2, y3 minus y1, plus x3, y1 minus y2. So this is the area of both the triangle. Add both of them. One, you'll get the area of triangle this as 29, and this area of triangle you are getting at 633/2. The total area of this quadrilateral is 121/2 square units. You can join BD also. Find the area of individual triangle and add both of the triangles to area of the triangle to get the area of this quadrilateral ABCD. Now in question number 2 of the same exercise, what is given? The base of an equilateral triangle with the side 2A lie on the y-axis. Lie on the y-axis, there is an equilateral triangle whose base lie on the y-axis and its length is 2A. So let us take one of the base of this triangle as AB on the y-axis. And naturally, if it is equilateral triangle, then it will be the perpendicular bisector of it. Then its coordinate will be A0A and 0 minus A. You have to find मिड पॉइंट ऑफ द बेस इज द ऑरिजिन, इसका मिड पॉइंट हमें दे रखा है, बाइसेक्टर दे रखा है. यू हैव टू फाइंड द वर्टिसेस, यू हैव टू फाइंड द वर्टिसेस ए एंड बी, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिफाइंड इट आउट. यू हैव टू फाइंड द वर्टेक्स सी. नाउ बिकॉज द बेस ऑफ दिस ट्राइंगल इज लाई, बिकॉज ओ इज मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए बी, देयरफोर दिस डिस्टेंस विल बी ए, दिस डिस्टेंस विल बी ए. ओ ए इज इक्वल टू ए एंड ओ बी इज इक्वल टू also a, therefore the coordinate of a will be 0a because it is in the positive direction of the y-axis, and the coordinate of a b will be 0 minus a because it is lie on the negative direction of the y-axis. Now this distance we don't know oc. Now this distance is 2a. You can use the Pythagoras theorem, ac square is equal to oa square plus oc square. So oa ac is 2a, oa is a, and oc you can easily find. Now simplified, it will be 4a square. Left में लेके जाइए, it will be OC square and under root 3a square will be equal to OC and this will be equal to OC. So OC will be equal to root 3a plus minus. This point can be here also and this point can be here also. Therefore the coordinate of C will be on the x-axis, it will be plus minus root 3a, 0. So the all the three vertices are there. That is, it may be root 3a, 0 minus root 3a, 0 and 0a and 0 minus a is the third vertex of this triangle ABC. So this is the question number 2. Now question number 3. Find the distance between the point P x1 y1 whose coordinates are x1 y1. There is a coordinate Q whose coordinate is x2 y2, and you have to find the distance PQ when it is parallel to y axis, and you have to find the distance PQ when it is parallel to x axis. If you try to draw the figure of this, let us take the point P, Q and X1, Y1, X2, Y2, and this line is parallel to Y axis in one of the first of the case. Now, when the PQ is parallel to, when PQ is parallel to Y axis, when a line is parallel to Y axis, then the X coordinate, then the x coordinates of P and Q must be equal because this and this point, the x will be same for those both the points. Therefore in this case x1 will be equal to x2, x1 will be equal to x2. Let us call B equal to capital X, let us call B equal to capital X, and the distance PQ will be x2 minus x1 ka whole square and y2 minus y1 ka whole square. Distance formula, aur kyunki ye dono same hai to ye 0 ho jayega aapka, ya isme x x rakh do dono, to it will be y2 minus y1 ka whole square. PQ is equal to this under root y2 minus y1 ka whole square, x2 minus x1 ka whole square, so it will be equal to y2 minus y1 ka distance. Why I have taken the mod sign? Because the distance cannot be negative. Similarly, when the line is parallel to x-axis, when the line is parallel to x-axis, suppose the line is parallel to x-axis, then its y coordinate will be same. So when PQ is parallel to x axis, then in that case the y coordinate will be equal to, their y coordinate will be same, their y coordinate will be same. So the distance PQ will be x2 minus x1 ka, x2 minus x1 ka whole square and y2 minus y1 ka whole square, and this distance will be 0 because its x coordinate is in this case will be 0. So therefore the distance will be modulus of x2 minus x1 because the distance between the two points cannot be negative. So this is the distance when the line is parallel to x-axis, x2 minus x1 ka mod. And when the line is parallel to y-axis, then the distance between the two points which is parallel to y-axis will be mod y2 minus y1. Okay, we'll continue in the next lecture. Thank you.